Yeah, I think we've got a ways to go. We have a 35% increase in the money supply since the beginning of March. We have not had that increase in liquidity for 75 years. I mean, more than twice the increase in liquidity in the entire year that followed the Lehman bankruptcy. And that liquidity is still going to be going into the stock market. I still think we're selling about 20 times next year's earnings in a zero interest rate environment. And I think we may beat next year by 5 to 10%, because I think we're going to have a spending boom in 2021 with all this buildup of liquidity. And once the fears of the pandemic and we get the therapeutics, et cetera, I think all this money is going to be flowing right into the economy and into the stock market.
But does it depend on another stimulus increasing that money in people's wallets, especially for the millions of Americans that are still unemployed?
Yeah. 10%? I do think that they're going to come to a deal. I'm very disappointed it hasn't come to a deal yet. It seems like there's a lot of political posturing, which you can understand, less than 3 months until, the national elections. It's over the, is it going to be $600 or $400 over the standard amount? Both sides agree on a lot of the other factors that have to do there. I think it's posturing. I think we will get a deal that will come through. It'll just see which side thinks there's going to be some political advantage to standing firm for a while.
So Professor, I mean, you just listed a couple of the short-term risks to the market, whether that's a stimulus bill or the election. Are they significant enough for you to want to take some money off the table, take some profits because of the likelihood or risk of a short-term pullback? Or is that money supply, that liquidity argument for the next 18 months just far too powerful for you to even want to risk missing out on?
Yeah, I think it really even overwhelms the politics. I know about, and I've talked about if there's a Democratic sweep, higher taxes. But I really think the increase in the liquidity, and don't forget, if there's going to be a Democratic sweep, there's going to be a lot of spending. You're still going to have even more debt, more spending that's going to be feeding into the market. Yep, there will be more taxes, and that's something to consider. But, all the forces, I think, the liquidity buildup, there's a Democratic administration, more spending. Unemployment's going to stay high. The Fed is going to stay at zero. And as I mentioned, I remember mentioning back in April saying I thought there was going to be inflation in 2021, 2022. People said, Professor Sigel, are you crazy? I mean, there's only deflation. Oil was negative. Now more and more people are beginning to say, hey, where is this liquidity going? And it's going into commodities. We see it in gold. We see it in silver. And it goes into assets that are backed by real assets, such as stocks. I call for the end of the 39-year bull market in bonds that started in 1981. I don't think we'll ever see yields on long-term bonds as low as we have this year looking back. And what that means is firms
really?
That
we just saw the record low a week ago.
I know. We have a 0.5%, and now it's about 67 basis points. I still think maybe that week ago is going to be the low. I think that is going to be low. I don't think there's going to be negative interest rates in the U.S. because I think there's going to be inflation next year. And I think bondholders are going to say, hey, I need more compensation than 50 basis points to hold 10-year paper. I think that will send bond interest rates higher. Moderate inflation, 3, 4, 5% is good for the stock market.
Right,
high inflation is bad.